In March 1972, I came back to Greece from the United States, where I have studied oceanography and hydrographic engineering. And I was assigned to the Greek Hydrographic Office in charge of the cartographic and survey programs. And of course, as liaison officer with international organization, and especially with the IHO. I was very lucky to start my career by participating next month, April 1972, in the 3rd International Hydrographic Conference in Monaco, escorting my hydrographer. It was a huge experience where I observed the way that the conference was operating, the discussions, the debates, the decisions that reached on various technical, administrative, and financial issues, and of course see how the conference was discussing and operating at that time. I had the opportunity to meet some very well-known hydrographers at that time and observe the way that they were discussing the various hydrographic issues, which was a very big school for me, participating for the first time. I spent 30 years at the Greek Hydrographic Office, and in 1993, I became its hydrographer. In the conference of 2002, I was honored to be elected as president of the directing committee of the conference, exactly 30 years after my first participation in the 10th International Hydrographic Conference, and be re-elected in 2007 for a second term. I think that it was a fantastic way to start and conclude my hydrographic career. I would say that, first of all, I love hydrography, and if I had a second chance, I would follow the same way of my hydrographic career. I think that the establishment of the organization in 1921, I consider it as the major achievement of the period where a few member states got together and established the organization. One of main tasks of which was to draft guidelines and procedures so that charts and publications could be understood and read by all the mariners, regardless of the language that they were speaking. And I think that that was a major achievement, a first major achievement in issues concerning safety at sea. I will have to mention two other issues that I consider that they are achievements, notable achievements in that period. The first one has to do with the convention. The convention that was drafted in 67, and it was accepted by member states in 70, provided the principles on which the organization was operating for almost 30 years. In the conference of 2002, member states had decided to revisit the convention in order for the organization to become more efficient, effective, and responsive to the maritime requirements as we move in the 21st century. In the extraordinary conference in 2005, the Strategic Planning Working Group that had been established to study this issue presented a draft of the revised convention. And here we have to notice a few major and important changes. First of all, it introduced the Secretary General instead of a directing committee who is accountable to the organization. Established for the first time the council that meets every year in order to consider all the major issues. Established an assembly instead of a conference, where the assembly meets every year, every 3 years, considering the strategic issues and accelerating the work that has to be done. Another major issue is that they put in place simplified procedures for states to become to become members of the organization. The other achievement that I consider that is very important is the application of new technologies. New technologies revolutionize the work of the organization and hydrographic offices, where the products, charts, updating, distribution, data that they were collected and they were disseminated, they put it in a much better form, a way, enhancing in this way the safety of navigation. And of course, the new technology was picked up by manufacturers, which they produce sophisticated, effective, and more accurate equipment. We can mention GPS, ECDIS, which uses CNCs, seismic sonars, underwater unmanned vehicles, laser hydrography, and of course, the use of internet. All these, they have contributed significantly to safety and to the protection of the environment. I think that the most important challenge that the organization is facing is the lack of modern surveying. We have almost 50% of the coastal areas are either not surveyed or surveyed not to modern standards. And this compromises safety to navigation. I think that the organization, in consultation with the hydrographic offices, regional hydrographic commissions, and other organizations, must put in place procedures so that the collection of data to be accelerated. Mm-hmm. Connected to that, I would say that there is a second issue that affects capacity building. There are many staff from various states, and especially from developing states, that they receive training through the capacity building program of the organization. But these persons that we come from developing states, going back to the countries, they do not have the hydrographic means in order to put in place the training that they have received. They do not have a hydrographic launch, they do not have an eco-sounder, they do not have a positioning system. So they cannot contribute by collecting data information. I do understand that this is a very difficult issue, but I believe that the organization must see more deeply into this issue so that people that they receive this training, otherwise we have experienced in the past that they make their ways to other countries. And this is loss of money of the organization and experience. I want briefly to mention two other issues. The first one has to do with the development of the marine spatial data infrastructure. We know that this is a difficult issue. We know that states, through this infrastructure, are enabling to various medical, technical, environmental issues that will provide the means for the state to perform better, and especially the marine or the hydrographic component of that infrastructure. A few things have been done. The first big discussion started in Rostock, Germany, in a conference in 2005. I think that 15 years after this first conference, not many things have been achieved. And personally, I think that the organization has to take some firm actions in order to accelerate the procedure. The second issue, and the last one, has to do with the Arctic. We know very well, and it has been noted by the Arctic Council, that the area of the Arctic is lacking navigational charts. With the increasing of the human activity in the area, like gas and oil exploration, fishing, tourism, but most important of all, shipping, charts need to be available as soon as possible. And I think that the organization, in cooperation with the surrounding states and with other organizations like IMO must put in place some firm programs with a timetable in order to provide the appropriate charge. And the second issue affecting safety and of course sets a rescue operation is for the organization with the island IMO to put in place a very effective marine safety information system.